We are at Westerplatte Peninsula, or should I call it Westerplatte Spit, because it was created by the river, which is somewhere there behind the trees, the Vistula River. It is the memorial, the war memorial, which can be seen by those graves. In fact, out of those graves, only one is full. The rest are empty. We don't know what happens to the bodies, but that will come later. This place is known as the place where the Second World War started, where Hitler attacked Poland. He attacked here. Of course, in many other places in Poland, that was not the only place to have been attacked by Hitler, by his army, but this is like a symbol of 7 days resistance of the Polish soldiers. The order, the Polish order, was to resist 12 hours. The German order was to take as soon as possible. Some say half an hour, some say an hour, 30 minutes, 60 minutes. In fact, Westerplatte resisted for 149 hours, or if you wanted to prefer it in minutes, 8,945, as far as I remember, minutes. Quite a while, we could say, today. As I said, this is the symbol of the German attack in Poland. Some of those trees still remember what happened on the first, from the 1st till the 7th of September 1939. We know that on the 1st of September, the Germans attacked with the famous Schleswig-Holstein battleship, which was moored somewhere there, behind those trees, and that little hut that can be seen in the very, very distance. That's the guardhouse number one. And Schleswig-Holstein, with the huge guns, shelled Westerplatte, which is a tiny place, in fact. The spit is about 1.5 kilometers long and about half a kilometer wide. And the first attack on the 1st of September at 4:45, this is how the tradition says, was not successful, so the Germans didn't take Westerplatte. It was a shock. It was a surprise. The Poles resisted. And on the next day, on the 2nd of September, the Germans brought the aircraft. About 50 Stuka bombers bombed Westerplatte for about half an hour to 45 minutes in the late afternoon, about 6 o'clock in the afternoon. From the news, the information that we have from the defenders of Westerplatte, there was a great destruction. By the way, that little cemetery that we just visited was built after the war on the place of the guardhouse number 5, which was completely destroyed, burying the defenders within. Speaking of the defenders, it's good to say how many Poles were and how many Germans were attacking them. It was about 200 Poles, some say 185, some say 210. It depends if we count the civilian workers, militarized or not. How about the German troops? Well, in fact, Wehrmacht came in here on the 3rd of September, so Gdańsk was attacked by the militarized Gdańsk-Danzig troops, which were the police troops and had no right, according to the Treaty of Versailles agreement, had no right to attack the Polish side. By the way, Westerplatte, why? Which was Polish. The history is quite complicated, but it was given by the League of Nations to the Polish country to reload the armament. We have to remember the story, the history of Poland. The story says that Poland lost independence, being a kingdom, in the 18th century, and it regained it in the 20th century after the First World War. But Gdańsk or Danzig as it was called, was not given back to Poland. Mathematically speaking, out of more than 1,000 years history of Gdańsk, it should have been given to Poland, back to Poland, because for about 600 years it had belonged to Poland. But it was the great politics that counted, not reasonable decisions, so Gdańsk became a free city. And the problems started when Poland was in a state of war with Bolshevik Russia, which attacked Poland in 1919, and 1920 there was a Battle of Warsaw. Poland won the war, surprisingly. And nevertheless, Poland was called by the Western countries, among them Germany, a seasonal country. Nobody wanted to believe that anything good could happen, that Poland could be successful. Nevertheless, Poland was successful, and if ever you look at the map of Poland and you see the port of Gdynia, some 30 kilometers north of Gdańsk, west of Gdańsk, remember that, because Gdynia was the Polish answer to the Treaty of Versailles, when port of Gdańsk, which you can see slightly there behind the trees, when that port of Gdańsk was not given back to Poland and Poland had not much chance to do the business through here. Shortening the story, Poland was attacked on the 1st of September 1939 by the Germans and on the 17th of September 1939 by the Russians. So once again, Poland was parted and alone fought for more than a month, whilst Westerplatte itself was like the separate story where the Polish troops resisted, as I said, for 7 days. On the 2nd, as I mentioned before, there was a bombing of Westerplatte. The Germans were very much surprised, because when they attacked on the 3rd, the Poles were already ready. The remaining Poles gathered themselves together and they were ready to resist further. On the 7th of September, there was again the attack. Well, 7 days, there were nearly constant and notorious attacks by the Germans, and on the 7th of September the Polish troops decided to surrender, especially that the army barracks were destroyed and that people were wounded and there was no food and no water. The artesian well was destroyed on the 2nd of September during the bombing. We shall soon go to the army barracks and I'll tell you more.